It's bold. It's eyebrow raising. It's a little bit random. A new reason to stay up late on Wednesday nights. Your on-screen gossip magazine. Introducing Big Brother Confidential. Jam-packed with all the hottest topics in the house. So put your feet up and settle in for all the unseen action in the Big Brother house. Coming up in our first edition of Big Brother Confidential, Shanae shows signs of cracking. Ben opens up about gay parenting. Zoe sets her sights on George. Bradley sheds his inhibitions. And Ryan needs to watch his back. The new housemates had only been in a few days when tensions flared between two of the boys.
Yeah, I think we have to.
When Ben was talking yesterday,
yeah.
Just chatting, like, normal conversation, you know, and we're saying, you know, everyone here is, you know, pretty diverse and, you know, the backgrounds, the type of jobs that they've got and you know, George goes to me, most people here have got, you know, been to university. So then I just thought, well, Ben was sitting up and, you know, I thought, Ben, like, I haven't, he was the last housemate to come in, I haven't really spoken to him that much of what he does.
Yeah.
You know, so then I've just gone to him, so you've got a university degree, and he's, what do you say? He said something like,
what do you want to know? this time of the night. Why would you ask such a ridiculous question at this time of the night? Of course I've got a degree.
Like a simple question.
Oh, no, it's Ryan.
I'm always enthralled when you have a question for me, Ryan. Oh, I just want to engage.
Yeah.
I just thought it was an interesting question at this time of the night. God.
I wanted to see Ben do his
question. So sorry.
Look, I've got a pretty good high tolerance level of people, but I just hate rude people.
It was like 3 a.m, I was going to sleep, and he's like, oh, he said 6 words to me in the entire 3 days I've been here, and he's like, 2 days, and then he's like, Benjamin, you got a university degree?
I reckon it's because he can't keep up with the conversation. He wants to find a quantitative sort of measurement to say, I'm smarter than you.
Yes.
I think he's just a rude person, to be honest.
Mm.
We interrupt this program for a world first Big Brother event. It's Bradley's first boob touch.
Hey, come on, just give it a little poke.
This is really weird.
Hey, just give it a little poke. Go on. Did you just boob him? Do it again.
I was like, I don't want to look.
He's like, I'm not looking.
You got Anthony's first tit touch.
Well, yeah, it wasn't even a grab though. It was a poke. It was a poke at the cleavage.
It was more than he's ever poked before.
I think so too. It was like, it was an above. This is what, like, this, it was at.
Yeah.
It wasn't a nipple, it wasn't an under.
He's probably,
it wasn't even an under hole.
He's probably felt more with a slight graze in a crowded room or something.
Maybe that's why he stays sober, so he can.
Oh, sorry about that.
To pass this week's task, all you need to do is dance.
Aristocratic British person saying beer can is exactly the same as a Jamaican person saying bacon.
Say it. Beer can.
Beer can. I'd like to get a beer can.
Oh, yeah.
Can I have some beer can? Yeah. That was a funny one that I heard.
Hi, Big Brother.
Stacey. Layla.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you?
What can Big Brother do for you?
I think the question is, what can we do for you?
Yeah. Do you fart?
Oh my God, Layla just farted! Oh! Big brother!
Oh God. Oh, sorry about
Big
that.
Big brother, can I ask you a question?
You may.
Do you actually look like an older version of Justin Bieber?
That's a really random question.
Because it's Big Bieber.
Big Brother looks like Big Brother.
Yeah.
Is there anything else?
Right. We're going to do a little something for you.
If you wish.
Layla obviously was quite un-Australian before she hopped into this little house. And I thought, you know what? I see a little diamond in the rough here and I'm going to take her and I'm going to just sharpen her up a little bit and I'm going to teach her about how to be Australian. So we did a little dance and I thought I'd just like, just we thought we could do it for you.
Big Brother's waiting.
Oh,
okay. 5, 6, 7. Me footy socks, me stubbies, me wife beater, me BB, me Tim Tam, because I'm Australian.
Big Brother is sure that Australia will be proud.
To save Sharnay, call 1902-559504, SMS Sharnay to 199-5599 or vote on Facebook.
I hate these mirrors.
Yeah, they're good.
They're not even mirrors. They're like, I'm like, I can't even see myself. It's like being in the dark and trying to look into a mirror.
Is there a river in Adelaide?
Yeah, the River Torrens.
Is it yuck?
Yeah, it's rank.
Would you rather drink a bucket of that water?
Oh, hypotheticals, good. Oh,
or a pint.
Love this.
A pint of piss.
But a bucket. Who's from
piss?
A bucket.
Is it like your own piss?
Let me extrapolate some more about this, because it grows. So yeah. A pint of stranger's piss, lukewarm.
Ooh.
Actually no, chilled. It's been chilled overnight. Or a bucket of Adelaide River water.
Yeah, I'll take the piss.
Alright.
I'd take the river water.
Dude. Piss.
You don't know like what he like what the stranger has. He's gonna have like an STI or something.
I'll cop an STI. 600 strangers piss in the river.
Would you rather sleep with a real life Marge Simpson? As in she's yellow. Bitch is yellow. She's also two dimensional. Or Roseanne.
Oh, Marge Simpson. Marge. Oh, that's disgusting.
Marge.
That is, that's deplorable.
Hands down, Marge Simpson, bro. Sure.
Would you rather sweat paprika?
Paprika? Isn't that like a herb?
It's like a red spice.
Red spice.
It's red, bright red. Or once a year, no, make that once a month, you shit involuntary at any time.
So you sweat.
So you can either live like a sweat-free life where you don't sweat, you know, you try to keep everything cool, or if you do get sweaty, you know, you'll just get this red glaze all over you. It's not dangerous, it just looks odd. Or once every month, the situation totally unknowns to you, you shit yourself. I mean, you could be on the toilet and it happens, and that would be truly a blessing.
No, I reckon I'll take the involuntary shitting.
Would you wear a nappy?
Yeah, there's ways around it.
I'd take the sweating paprika.
You covered in red non-stop. You sweat all the time. Even your ball sweat's red. You know?
Yeah.
Doesn't that look weird?
Especially the ball sweat.
No,
that would just look normal for me.
Yeah.
Just
how is this TV like this is no interesting TV.
Sure ain't.
Do you worry your food is safe enough to eat? Well, worry no more. Introducing the Thermo Sensor Thingy, using advanced infrared specialized scientific technology to measure the temperature of your food. Just listen to these ecstatic customers who've tried it out for themselves.
It's a great idea, yeah, because I wasn't expecting anything like this.
Amazing.
But that's not all. Not only does the Thermo Sensor Thingy measure the temperature of food, it measures the temperature of absolutely everything. Just look at this.
Oh, here we go.
You hit it.
Can you see how hot my junk is?
It's your body temperature.
38.
It's off to
your
What's gold, sweetheart?
Oh, really?
It's fucking 28.
Oh, I'm
gonna
tear my pants.
Oh, well, we should do that. Direct it.
Yes, do
it. Yeah, there we go.
33.
Oh.
33, not hot enough.
What do we got?
Calm,
34.
And if you buy in the next 10 seconds, we'll throw in these big grass mound thingies for free. That's right, big grass mound thingies. We're not sure what you can do with them, but Ryan and George seem to know. So hurry, get your credit card ready to call this number now. We told you to hurry.
He's gonna fart.
3, 2, 1.
Jumped up to 30! Jumped up to 30!
The thermosensor thingy. Just get it.
They call me Ghetto Betty, the Runo Sexy I like to get sweaty at home in bed with men. I'm a real sassy lass and I got much class, but if you step in my grass, I bust a cap in your ass. Boom. Boom. If you're gonna be my grill, I take another pill. Got ape shit on your ass, I throw you down a hill. Boom. Boom. Cruise around on my L place, do wheelies on your lawn. You come out to fight, I'll do the effing horn.
She just keeps going.
No one needs on a Sunday. Freedom is my goal. Beto's in the alleyway. That is how I roam.
That shit is whack.
Josh may have dated more than 100 women, but he shared with Layla that he still has insecurities with the fairer sex.
I don't know how I even get, like, when I got a girlfriend and stuff like that. Like, you know, a little bit of jealousy kicks in. And it's like not,
do you get jealous?
Not yeah, kind of do. It sucks,
and I try
not to. I guess it's because maybe just get insecure in a relationship. So I always just think that they're gonna go off and find something better.
Oh no, they wouldn't.
Yeah, so I don't know though. It's just what I always think,
maybe
which
I
is
think
shit,
that about
and I try
you,
and I try not to. Yeah, I get that a lot. You know what I mean? Like girls going, oh yeah. You're in a band, like, you're gonna go up and do this and this and this and this.
But
and
you're genuinely not.
Well.
You would never cheat. Have you ever cheated?
Yeah.
See, this is
it's shit. Like.
That's probably what the problem is.
Well, I think that then still it lies within me. It's like, well, okay, if I'm capable of doing that, then what are they capable of doing?
Yeah, that's exactly what it is with guys.
Yeah.
You're paranoid and jealous
yeah.
about the situation because you're doing it.
Mm.
Ryan! Come give us a flex.
Never ask me for a flex. I'm a bit offended, Andrew.
It makes me so proud.
Do you want a flex now?
Yeah.
Please.
I'll give you a flex now. I'll do like a strip tease. Hey.
You're supposed to grab their hands and rub it across your razor.
No, no,
oh, no. Wait, no, touch my spine.
I went from real, real excited to like, what?
To save Estelle, call 1902 559505, SMS Estelle to 199-55999 or vote on Facebook. The day we all feared is upon us. The arrival of beings from another world. Under the cover of darkness, the house has been infiltrated. One of these people is not like the others. One of these people is the Visitor. In the confines of the Big Brother house, it's only a matter of time before housemates start to go a little crazy. But in recent days, on closer inspection by Big Brother Confidential, the behaviour of just one housemate suggests they could be from another planet entirely. They've been seen offering an intergalactic greeting. Thank you. conducting intense research into the human form. And communicating with the mothership. But more footage must be examined before we can accurately determine which housemate is the visitor.
That's right, girls.
Run for us.
Slow-mo, come on, let me see more graceful jogging.
Yeah.
Very good.
Oh, it's like a cigarette. So, darling.
You guys can get back to being normal now if you want.
I would love Layla's boobs. Look at them.
I couldn't stop looking at them in the pool.
Either. They just were glamorous.
I was just watching them.
They were brown, like covered in water, and they were just sitting there all perfect.
Really? I was just looking at them, and I just wanted to, motorboat you like a motherfucker.
The only thing you'd look at. But they'll be gone if I diet. If I keep dieting, they'll be gone soon. And I don't want that. I'd rather just keep what I have and just get liposuction everywhere else. Mm. I'd like a little... This sounds really weird, but I'd like a little bit of Botox there so then it lifts. No, because you can either have Botox where it lifts or gets rid of the wrinkle. So I want it to lift there so my eyes are a little bit purged.
Yeah, me too.
Really?
Like, yeah. Like, when I smile,
like a little tiny bit like that. So when my makeup's on, it looks really nice.
Can I do it? I'll come up like a dolphin.
Yeah, come up like a dolphin. Yeah. No, you gotta swim over.
Oh, yeah.
Do it.
Come here,
I came in here to be out of my comfort zone, to try and push the boundaries of myself psychologically, but things are starting to get to me. I'm finding it hard to not compete with these people that just seem to want the attention from everybody all the time. I like intelligent conversation, I like to be involved in things, but just some things that I think are just so, conversations are so, oh.
Josh, longest you've gone without a wank. 28 days is me. It's marked in my year 12 diary.
I'm now questioning myself as to whether I am an interesting person, I am an intelligent person. It makes me then get into my head, which is not a good thing at all.
I've got to confront somebody about this because they've pigeonholed me straight away.
Who have you got to be confront? You don't.
Michael. He turns to me and he goes, I know why you're here, because you're here to look glamorous. And it's like, dude. No.
I'm sorry, but you haven't sat down with me and actually had a conversation. I'm not going to you. I don't do that, honey. People come to me if they want to find out who I am. He's just a big mouth with a load of intelligence.
Shanae, is there anything else?
No, I think that's about it at the moment. It was actually really nice just to get off my chest.
Oh, cuddle me. Estelle gets really into it. Oh. Oh, I totally got Little Spoon for Vic. Aren't you just a cuddle bunny? Hey there. Cool. Come on, girlies. Oh, I need someone to push my mattress up.
Why?
Look, I got a big gap.
That's what she said.
My gap.
Yeah, no, but my pillow's full.
You just missed my great. That's what she said.
Well, let's wait until Michael comes back in, because he's a man.
He's a man.
And they've got muscles and.
Just.
Well, you're all snuggled. What you think? Are you gonna get out?
I could push it.
Do it.
Do it then.
Do it.
I have to get off it actually, because it's too heavy. So I'm coming to the other side of the woods.
Too heavy.
That's good.
Thanks.
Thanks for your manliness.
And I'm a bit of a hero.
To save Layla, call 1902 559 508, SMS Layla to 199 5599, or vote on Facebook. As they become fast friends, Layla and Angie bond over a good old-fashioned girls' talk about boys.
I always go for the wrong guys, though. I always go for the wrong guys. And they've always been arses, but it's so nice to be, like, on the arm of somebody that all girls fancy.
Like a bit of arm candy and stuff.
Yeah, like, yeah. I like arm candy. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But then that's not good.
No.
Because they will always be thriving for the attention of girls.
The thing is I there's been so many times where I've just fallen into relationships.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Like, it's never been like, let me take you out on dates, let me wine you and dine you, let me do this, let me do that. It's always been like, let's hang out a couple of times.
Yeah.
Like, I'll set yours a couple of times, you set mine a couple of times. And I was like, I just think to myself, it'd just be so nice to be wined and dined and to be chased after.
I found that guys over here don't chase you.
They don't.
No.
And that shits me so much. It's good. I know they're nice guys, but it's like,
you just want that.
What do I need to do? Like, what do I need to look like? What do I need to act like for someone just to be like, you know what? Stuff it. I really like you, and I'm gonna show you that.
It's always an ulterior motive to everything with guys.
I just feel like, okay, this might sound horrible, but like, I almost can't blame the guys. Because I feel like girls these days, like...
I just put it out.
They put it out there, you know, like, they give it up too easy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So guys are like, why would I chase after something when I know that I could literally go to the next table of girls at this club and
probably just get one of that. Yeah.
So I feel like I'm getting punished for trying to be a good girl.
Yeah.
Because there's, like, 20 other slutty girls
that'll quite happily
be like, yeah, my pants are already off.
Yeah.
Yeah. I've always gone for a guy like George.
Yeah.
If George came up to me and tried to kiss me,
oh, good God.
I'm here to cleanse the pool.
I reckon George would make a girl happy. He'd keep a girl smiling all the time.
It's a trouble for me.
This will be good.
Ding, ding, ding.
Once you can buy the house outright, that's when I'll buy a house.
Yeah. Well, became a whole lot more attractive.
How you doing?
I was so much more attractive than just talking there as it kept smiling. Like, yeah, yeah. Like, melting.
Amazingly, it took until day 4 for the housemates to realise something about Sarah wasn't completely natural.
You both fake. Did anyone else know that?
Yeah.
Can I touch?
Like fake.
Her boobs are fake.
Ah.
Are your boobs fake?
I'm sorry.
Hang on. There you go. It's a bit better. How much were they? Have a pop of jiggle if you want. Did you buy them out, right? I did buy them out, right?
Yeah. What size did they go from?
When did you get them? Yeah, it was, but worth it.
Like, what size were they before you got the boob job?
Oh, I'm so surprised because, like, normally I'm pretty good at being able to...
Yeah, I would have thought they were real. I thought they were real.
Well, I didn't get them too big.
Yeah, like, they're just, like, a classy size. Like, they're just, like...
They're still nice big, though.
Thanks,
yeah,
darling.
So what size were they before you got them done?
Like, oh, tiny little B, like, tiny, weeny little B.
And what
B?
Size are they now, C's or D's?
D, double D.
I want perfect boobs!
Every time I'm about to get on a plane, I just scope and I go, good looking girl, please God, please God. Because you've heard so many good stories about guys meeting their wives on planes.
Really?
I was in the airport, there's about like 50, I don't know, 50, 100 of us get on the plane, there's this smoke and blowing, I'm just like, I wonder if I'll be sitting next to her, eh?
Oh,
and now they're like, she comes and sits right next to me, and she's like, do you mind if I'll lean on you so I can sleep? I'm like, lean away, babe, lean away.
As the boys were getting to know each other, Ray posed an interesting question to Benjamin.
When me and my mates talk, we're always like, we make this joke, like, you know, because we've got our girlfriends and, you know, they're sort of a little bit expensive and things like that. And we always go, mate, oh my God, if we were just gay, we'd be laughing. We wouldn't have to pay for kids. We'd share clothes. Do you find that because you're gay, you do have more wealth? Like, a lot of gay people I know are very well-to-do.
Basically, you could say that my quality of life is better because I'm wearing the latest clothes or that I live in Toorak, but I'm sorry, the next level of life that I see my friends going through is that they will have children.
You want to have, you could still get
my boyfriend
kids,
and yeah. I are both so self-involved that we don't want to adopt another person's child out of fear of not loving that child as though it was our own. Yeah. We don't want to have a surrogacy where one of us donates sperm to have a baby that turns out to be one of our child. Because who will parent that child and love that child differently? And I also think I'm being bastardized as time goes on by being so spoiled by my gay culture that maybe I wouldn't be ready to have a child to be able to cut that off. Would I be ready to now eat my words and then have a child? I don't know.
Josh the rock star has taken Bradley under his wing and is teaching him how to get attention from the ladies.
And he goes, do you think you should help him? Or should show him the ways? I was like, well, maybe,
man,
I'll do that.
Our goal is to get you a hookup on Saturday night.
So we've just been, yesterday, Angie and I were in the pool just watching Bradley do his work on Estelle.
I was just talking to her.
She's got all this smoking body.
You're on, bro.
She's all right, you know?
He's keen.
I reckon you're on a winner there, bro.
He's keen.
Oh, well, you know, I guess I could if she was up for it. I wouldn't say no.
Seriously, man. Go. Now,
before Estelle, I have a bit of a strange request.
It's not, no, don't say strange.
Oh,
yes. Just walk up to a real cat.
Estelle,
like,
can you put sunscreen on my back for me?
1 second.
All righty, I can wait.
Hold that thought. You do. I nearly did it again.
Just be like, hey, Estelle, can you just chuck some of this into that?
OK.
No, yeah. You can make a mean Dijon,
so
once we win this
pod,
I'll make up a huge bash of
Dijon. You like? You feel
alright? I think if we get in this pool,
it'll help. In. Every part of me is like Michael.
Just slap some on.
Oh.
These pants
clip on. Oh, I love that that actually does clip on. Go in the shade.
Alrighty.
How good does it smell?
It's really nice. Yeah.
There you go.
Thank you. Yeah.
All done.
I'm going to put a bat unless you want it. Do you already have some?
That's a secret. Oh, did you tell no one?
Yeah.
What's your favourite cut of meat? Yeah, I love Wagyu. Like, you know, more fat, more grease. Ooh, that's hot, eh? You ever had one of your own cows? I'd love to have chickens. And then when their time comes, eat the chickens.
Since her romance with Ryan started, horse enthusiast Estelle has been a hot topic of conversation.
Yeah. She's like, I went to school with a bunch of horse riders. Like, I went to a horsey school. And I know that although she might say all this put on the front boys and stuff, I know that horse riders go to shows where they have to sleep in the back of their trailers.
Yeah.
Lots of boys around, and I know that things get heated. I know, yeah. Doesn't matter if she's from Melbourne, she still heads out of Melbourne for shows and stuff.
Yeah.
And I know exactly what goes on.
Yeah, I've so seen, you think she's playing the light on the sweetness of God.
Yeah, that's what I think.
Yeah.
But that's why she knows how to flirt, because she's spent time
Second
around boys.
Second nature. Totes jealous.
Totally jealous.
Totes
jealous. Jealousy, though.
Totes. Soup's jealous.
This is a mini little, like, it's just a little mini test, just to test where we're at. So, a father and his son driving towards the son's baseball game. This is set in America. Or perhaps an Americanized Australian family, who knows? So they're driving down the road, and he's late for the game, and he's the opening pitcher, so he puts on the gear, he starts heading a little bit fast. And motorbike swung outside the line of the traffic, and they've had to move out of it, and they've hit a bunch of trees head on. Father's killed instantly. The son's fairly badly wounded. And so the ambulance grab the young boy, and they're like, we need to get him to the like straight away.
Because he's not far off.
He's not in a good way. So they race him into the hospital, and the doctor looks down at the boy and goes, I can't operate on this kid. He's my son. Explain.
Oh, I love this sort of shit. Okay.
If none of you get this in 10 seconds.
Dude, we got asked this at my boarding school in year 12.
One,
a class of like 50
two,
people didn't get it.
3, 4, 5.
Because he had an affair with the mom.
The doctor was his mother.
You're all sexist.
Oh, the doctor
pigs.
Was his mom.
Yeah, I know.
Why can't women be doctors?
I was going to say.
But there you go.
Very important. You can have some sort of control about how far you go into the competition.
If I don't feel that someone's bringing the A game, then it gives me the power to get rid of them.
It gives my influence on what can be and what can change.
It means you can keep someone in the house or you can kick them out. You've got to use that power wisely.
Basically have control in my hands.
Very terrifying because I don't really want to hurt anyone's feelings.
It makes me really nervous. You can think of it strategically, vote for someone that you really don't like. I don't know, probably too much responsibility for me.
It's a great tool to have. It can really change the house.
Like, if there's a group of girls in a photo, they don't, like, group of dudes in a photo.
Just stand there.
Group of girls.
Girls are...
Yeah, the girls on the outside are doing that.
Yeah.
Or these ones.
I was doing under.
This is the police. Pull your vehicle over immediately.
Oh my god.
We surrender.
Where did you go?
Good afternoon, Constantine.
Under your top of it.
You got any idea why you've been pulled over today?
For being too sexy.
I think, personally, we were probably being a bit too distracting to the other drivers on the road.
Because our outfits are pretty amazing, totes amazeballs.
And I also think the fact that we were doing gymnastics and aerobics whilst driving a vehicle.
Regardless of all that, ladies, there's been reports of some funny business. A couple of clowns messing up my highway. Is that sounding familiar in any way?
It depends what you classify as funny business, because we're here to lol, you know?
All right, you jokers. What's in the boot?
We're almost there. We're just opening the boot here.
Oh, sorry. My apologies, ladies. It seems you actually are clowns.
You're right, buddy, man.
Let's put them on.
Just come round over here so I can take a look at you clowns. You did look a little suspicious, but you are clowns, so on your bike.
All right, so there were three pieces of string and they were in the desert, cruising down the desert. It was a really, really hot day. They send the far yonder and they go, oh my gosh, there's like a pub in the far yonder. That's so exciting. I'm going to get a beer. I'm going to get a beer. Anyway, they get up to the pub and the first piece of string is so flat out excited. He walks up to the bar and he's like, g'day, bartender, I'll just have a beer. And the bartender says, oh, look, probably come a long way, but I'm really sorry. We have a policy. We don't actually serve string here. There's actually a sign. We don't actually serve string here. I'm sorry, mate. He's like, oh, ripped off. Walks out and tells his mates, look, sorry, guys, they don't actually serve string here. And the other mates go, I told you so. Third piece of string goes, get out of my way. I'll sort this right out. He goes in, gets himself and he ruffles himself right up. Gets himself and he juggles himself around. Goes, hey, bartender. I want to have a beer, mate. He goes, mate, there's a sign up here. We don't serve string here. You're going to have to move on. I want three of you to go. And he went, mate, I'm afraid not.
I'm afraid. Oh, it's good. Yeah,
I like that. It's not a bad one.
When it comes to the subject of posing nude, Layla's got a strong opinion.
I would never send anybody a picture of me naked.
Josh is like, mental notes.
And it can always turn so different, bad, can't it?
Would you get naked for a magazine shoot?
Not naked, no. I wouldn't get naked. I wouldn't get naked in a magazine. I wouldn't get naked on TV. I wouldn't get...
No, I don't really like it. I'm quite prude about like that.
Just my nips and my vagina.
What?
Like, just like, you know, if I was like covering my nipples...
Yeah.
Or like something was covering my vagina...
Yeah.
I'd be okay.
Oh yeah, no, I mean like basically no clothes, but you can cover your modesty.
Well, I like did some professional shots. It's in posed nudity, like so she like I had underwear on, but she just positioned me in
so
a way
that you were naked.
That it looked like I was naked. It was so tasteful and it was so well done. I was just like, shit, yeah, I'd do this again.
Do it
like, because it wasn't skanky. It wasn't like, you know, soft porn or anything like that. It was just classy. I see images. I'm like, as long as you can't see anything, yeah. I'm happy.
Zoe has been feeling self-conscious about keeping the others awake with her snoring. So to make her feel better, Ben reveals he has sleeping issues of his own.
So in my sleep, I get up and I look for food, and sometimes I do it in the nude.
Sleep the whole time.
My boyfriend woke me up just recently and I was at the fridge with two Magnums and I don't even know, I eat ice cream and I was tandemly and he walked past and saw me and went Ben! And I went oh! I was like in complete shock, like terrified. The worst one was about 5 years ago. I woke up and I found a bar of Imperial leather soap next to my bed with two bite marks in it, but they were like attempted bite marks. And so I woke up and saw this bar of Imperial leather and I was like, I must have been like this. I'll just leave that for later. And have gone back to sleep.
The housemates have nominated. Vote now to save your favourites from Sunday's Big Brother eviction. Here are the details.
To save Sharnay, call 1902 559504. SMS Sharnay to 199 5599 or vote on Facebook. To save Estelle, call 1902 559505. SMS Estelle to 199 5599 or vote on Facebook. To save Layla, call 1902 559508. SMS Layla to 199 5599 or vote on Facebook.
The power to save is now in your hands, Australia. Get voting.
Aristocratic British person saying beer can is exactly the same as a Jamaican person saying bacon.
Say it, beer can.
Beer can. I'd like to get a beer can.
Oh, yeah.
Can I have some beer can? That was a funny one that I heard.
Hi, big brother.
Stacey, Layla.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you?
What can Big Brother do for you?
I think the question is, what can we do for you? Yeah. You fart. Oh my god, Layla just farted. Oh. 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 Big brother. Oh god. Oh, sorry about
Big
that.
Big brother, can I ask you a question?
You may.
Do you actually look like an older version of Justin Bieber?
That's a really random question.
Because it's Big Bieber?
Big Brother looks like Big Brother.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Is there anything else?
Right. We're going to do a little something for you.
If you wish.
Layla obviously was quite un-Australian before she hopped into this little house.
And I thought, you know what? I see a little diamond in the rough here, and I'm going to take her, and I'm going to just sharpen her up a little bit, and I'm going to teach her about how to be Australian. So we did a little dance, and I thought I'd just, like, just we thought we could do it for you.
Big Brother's waiting.
Oh, okay. 5, 6, 7. Me footy socks, me stubbies, me wife beater, me BB, me Tim Tam, because I'm Australian.
Big Brother is sure that Australia will be proud.
To save Sharnay, call 1902 559 504, SMS Sharnay to 1995 5999, or vote on Facebook.
I hate these mirrors.
Yeah, they're good.
They're not even mirrors. They're...
One.
Jumped up to 30! Jumped up to 30!
The thermosensor thingy. Just get it.
They call me Ghetto Betty, the Runo Sexy Ugh. I like to get sweaty at home and bend with men. I'm a real sassy lass, and I got much class, but if you step in my grass, I bust a cap in your ass. Boom. Boom. If you get up in my grill, I take another pill. Got ape shit on your ass, I throw you down a hill. Boom. Boom. Cruise around on my L place, do wheelies on your lawn. You come out to fight, I'll do the effing horn.
Just keep going.
No one is on a Sunday. Freedom is my goal. B-Day's in the alleyway. That is how I roam.
That shit is whack.
Josh may have dated more than 100 women, but he shared with Layla that he still has insecurities with the fairer sex.
I don't know how I even get, like, when I got a girlfriend and stuff like that. Like, you know, a little bit of jealousy kicks in. And it's like not,
do you get jealous?
Not, yeah, I kind of do. It sucks,
and I try
not to. I guess it's because maybe just get insecure in a relationship. So I always just think that they're gonna go off and find something better.
Oh no, they wouldn't.
Yeah, so I don't know. That it's just what I always think,
maybe
which
I
is shit. And
I try
not to. Yeah, I get that a lot. You know what I mean? Like girls going, oh yeah, you're in a band, like. You're gonna go up and do this and this and this and this.
But
and
you're genuinely not.
Well.
You would never cheat. Have you ever cheated?
Yeah.
See, this is
it's shit. Like.
That's probably what the problem is.
Well, I think that then still it lies within me. It's like, well, okay, if I'm capable of doing that, then what are they capable of doing?
Yeah, that's exactly what it is with guys.
Yeah.
You're paranoid and jealous
about
the situation because you're doing it.
Mm.
Ryan! Come give us a flex.
Never ask me for a flex. I'm a bit offended, Angie.
I really, it makes me so proud.
Do you want a flex now?
Yeah.
Please.
I'll give you a flex now. I'll do like a strip tease. Hey.
Eyebrow-raising. It's a little bit random. A new reason to stay up late on Wednesday nights. Your on-screen gossip magazine. Introducing Big Brother Confidential. Jam-packed with all the hottest topics in the house. So put your feet up and settle in for all the unseen action in the Big Brother house. Coming up in our first edition of Big Brother Confidential, Sharnay shows signs of cracking, Ben opens up about gay parenting, Zoe sets her sights on George, Bradley sheds his inhibitions, and Ryan needs to watch his back. The new housemates had only been in a few days when tensions flared between two of the boys.
Yeah, I think we have to.
How's when Ben was talking yesterday?
Yeah. I was chatting, like, normal conversation, you know, and we're saying, you know, everyone here is, you know, pretty diverse and, you know, the backgrounds, the type of jobs that they've got. And you know, George goes to me, most people here have got, you know, been to university. So then I just thought, well, Ben was sitting up, and, you know, I thought, Ben, like, he was the last housemate to come in. I haven't really spoken to him that much of what he does. Yeah. You know, just, so then I've just gone to him, so you've got a university degree. And he's, what do you say? He said something like,
what do you want to know? this time of the night. Why would you ask such a ridiculous question at this time of the night? Of course I've got a degree.
It's like a simple question.
Oh, no, it was Ryan.
I'm always enthralled when you have a question for me, Ryan. I just want to engage.
Yeah.
I just thought it was an interesting question at this time of the night. God.
I wanted to see Ben do his
best. So sorry.
Look, I've got a pretty good high tolerance level of people, but I just hate rude people.
It was like 3 a.m, I was going to sleep, and he's like, oh, he said 6 words to me in the entire 3 days I've been here, and he's like, 2 days, and then he's like,
excuse me.
Benjamin, you got a university degree?
I reckon it's because he can't keep up with the conversation. He wants to find a quantitative sort of measurement to say, I'm smarter than you.
Yes. I think he's just a rude person, to be honest.
Mm.
We interrupt this program for a world first Big Brother event. It's Bradley's first boob touch.
Come on, just give it a little poke.
This is really weird.
Just give it a little poke. Go on. Did you just boob him? Do it again.
I don't want to look.
He's like, I'm not looking.
You gave me first tit touch.
Well, yeah, it wasn't even a grab, though. It was a poke. It was a poke in the cleavage.
I think it was more than he's ever poked before.
I think so, too. It was an above. This is what I love. This sort of shit. Okay.
If none of you get this in 10 seconds,
dude, we got asked this at my boarding school in year 12.
One,
a class of like 50
two,
people didn't get it.
3, 4, 5.
Because he had an affair with the mom.
The doctor was his mother.
You're all sexist.
Oh, the doctor
pigs.
Is his mom.
Yeah, I know.
Why can't women be
doctors? I was
gonna
say.
But there you go.
Very important. You can have some sort of control about how far you go into the competition.
If I don't feel that someone's bringing the A game, then it gives me the power to get rid of them.
It gives my influence on what can be and what can change.
It means you can keep someone in the house or you can kick them out. You've got to use that power wisely.
Basically have control in my hands.
Very terrifying because I don't really want to hurt anyone's feelings.
Makes me really nervous. You can think of it strategically. Vote for someone that you really don't like. I don't know.
Probably too much responsibility for me.
It's a great tool to have. It can really change the house.
Like, if there's a group of girls in a photo, they don't... Like, group of dudes in a photo.
Just stand there.
Group of girls.
Girls are...
Yeah, the girls on the outside are doing that.
Yeah.
Or these ones.
I was doing under.
This is the police. Pull your vehicle over immediately.
Oh my god. We surrender. Where did you go?
Good answer, the ball called Stanoon.
Under your top of it.
You got any idea why you've been pulled over today?
For being too sexy.
I think, personally, we were probably being a bit too distracting to the other drivers on the road.
Because our outfits are pretty amazing, totes amazeballs.
And I also think the fact that we were doing gymnastics and aerobics whilst driving a vehicle.
Regardless of all that, ladies, there's been reports of some funny business. A couple of clowns messing up my highway. Is that sounding familiar in any way?
It depends what you classify as funny business, because we're here to lol, you know?
All right, you jokers. What's in the boot?
We're almost there. We're just opening the boot here.
Oh, sorry. My apologies, ladies. It seems you actually are clowns.
You're funny, man.
Let's put them on.
Just come round over here so I can take a look at you clowns. You did look a little suspicious, but you are clowns, so on your bike.
So there were three pieces of string and they were in the desert, cruising down the desert. It was a really, really hot day. They say in the final...
Depends what you classify as funny business, because we're here to lol, you know?
All right, you jokers. What's in the boot?
We're almost there. We're just opening the boot here.
Oh, sorry. My apologies, ladies. It seems you actually are clowns.
You're our body, man.
Hey, let's put them on.
Just come round over here so I can take a look at you clowns. You did look a little suspicious, but you are clowns, so on your bike.
So there were three pieces of string and they were in the desert, cruising down the desert. It was a really, really hot day. They see in the far yonder and they go, oh my gosh, there's like a pub in the far yonder. That's so exciting. I'm going to get a beer. I'm going to get a beer. Anyway, they get up to the pub and the first piece of string is so flat out excited. He walks up to the bar and he's like, g'day bartender, I'll just have a beer. And the bartender says, oh, look, you've probably come a long way, but I'm really sorry. We have a policy. We don't actually serve string here. There's actually a sign. We don't actually serve string here. I'm sorry, mate. He's like, pipped off. Walks out and tells his mates, look, sorry guys, I don't actually serve string here. And the other mates go, I told you so. Third piece of string goes, get out of my way. I'll sort this right out. He goes in, gets himself and he ruffles himself right up, gets himself and he juggles himself around. Goes, hey bartender, I'll just have a beer, mate. He goes, mate, there's a sign up here. We don't serve string here. You're going to have to move on. I want three of you to go. And he went, mate, I'm afraid not.
I'm afraid. Oh, it's good. Yeah,
like it's not a bad one.
When it comes to the subject of posing nude, Layla's got a strong opinion.
I would never send anybody a picture of me naked.
Josh is like mental notes.
And it can always turn so different, bad, can't different. It?
Would you get naked for a magazine shoot?
Not naked, no. I wouldn't get naked. I wouldn't get naked in a magazine. I wouldn't get naked on TV. I wouldn't get...
No, I don't really like it. I'm quite prude about like that.
Just my nips and my vagina.
What?
Like, just like, you know, if I was like covering my nipples...
Yeah.
Or like something was covering my vagina...
Yeah.
I'd be okay.
Oh yeah, no, I can't. Mean like, no, I mean like basically yeah. No clothes, but you can cover your modesty.
Well, I like did some professional shots. It's in posed nudity, like so she like I had underwear on, but she just positioned me in
so
a way
like that you were naked.
That it looked like I was naked. It was so tasteful, and it yeah. was so well done. I was just like, shit, yeah, I'd do this again.
Do it
like, because it wasn't skanky. It wasn't like, you know, soft porn or anything like that. It was just classy. I see images. I'm like, as long as you can't see anything, yeah. I'm happy.
Zoe has been feeling self-conscious about keeping the others awake with her snoring. So to make her feel better, Ben...
Is there anything else?
No, I think that's about it at the moment. It was actually really nice just to get off my chest.
Oh, cuddle me.
Estelle gets really into it.
Oh. Oh, I totally got a little spoon for Vic.
Aren't you just a cuddle bunny?
Hey
there.
Come on, girly. Oh, I need someone to push my mattress up.
Why?
Look, I got a big gap.
Well, what,
that's what she said.
My gap.
Yeah, no, but my pillow's full.
You just missed my great. That's what she said.
Well, let's wait until Michael comes back in because he's a man.
He's a man.
And they've got muscles and.
Just.
Well, no, you're all snuggled. What you think? Are you gonna get out?
I could push it.
Do it.
Do you know, it then.
Do it.
I have to get off it actually because it's too heavy. So I'm coming
to
the other side of the
woods. Too heavy.
Thanks.
Thanks
for your manliness.
Thanks. I'm a bit of a hero.
To save Layla, call 1902 559508, SMS Layla to 1995999, or vote on Facebook. As they become fast friends, Layla and Angie bond over a good old-fashioned girls' talk about boys.
I always go for the wrong guys, though. I always go for the wrong guys.
and they've always been arses, but it's so nice to be, like, on the arm of somebody that all girls fancy.
Like a bit of arm candy and stuff.
Yeah, like, yeah. I like arm candy. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But then that's not good.
No.
Because they will always be thriving for the attention of girls.
The thing is I like, there's been so many times where I've just fallen into relationships.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Like, it's never been like, let me take you out on dates, let me wine you and dine you, let me do this, let me do that. It's always been like, oh, let's hang out a couple of times.
Yeah,
like, I'll
stay at
yours a couple of times, you stay at mine a couple of times. And I was like, I just think to myself, it'd just be so nice to be wined and dined and to be chased after.
I found that guys over here don't chase you.
They don't.
No.
And that shits me so much. It's good. I know they're nice guys, but it's like,
you just want
that. What do I need to do? Like, what do I need to look like? What do I need to act like for someone just to be like, you know what? Stuff it. I really like you, and I'm gonna show you that.
It's always an ulterior motive to everything with guys.
I just feel like, okay, this might sound horrible, but like, I almost can't blame the guy.
Is there a river in Adelaide?
Yeah, the River Torrens.
Is it yuck?
Yeah, it's rank.
Would you rather drink a bucket of that water?
Oh, hypotheticals, good. Oh,
or a pint.
Love this.
A pint of piss.
A bucket. Who's from
piss?
A bucket.
Is it like your own piss?
Let me extrapolate some more about this, because it grows. So yeah. A pint of stranger's piss, lukewarm.
Ooh.
Actually no, chilled. It's been chilled overnight. Or a bucket of Adelaide River water.
Yeah, I'll take the piss.
Alright.
I'd take the river water.
Dude. Piss.
You don't know like what he like what the stranger has. He's gonna have like an STI or something.
I'll cop an STI. 600 strangers piss in the river.
Would you rather sleep with a real life Marge Simpson? As in she's yellow. Bitch is yellow. She's also two dimensional. Or Roseanne.
Oh, Marge Simpson. Marge. Oh, that's disgusting.
Marge.
That is, oh, that's deplorable.
Hands down, Marge Simpson, bro, for sure.
Would you rather sweat paprika?
Paprika, isn't that like a
herb? It's like a red spice.
Red spice.
It's red, bright red. Or once a year, no, make that once a month, you shit involuntary at any time.
So you sweat.
So you can either live like a sweat-free life where you don't sweat, you know, you try to keep everything cool, or if you do get sweaty, you know, you'll just get this red glaze all over you. It's not dangerous, it just looks odd. Or once every month, the situation totally unknowns to you, you shit yourself. I mean, you could be on the toilet and it happens, and that would be truly a blessing.
No, I reckon I'll take the involuntary shitting.
Would you wear a nappy?
Yeah, there's ways around it.
I'd take the sweating paprika.
You covered in red non-stop. You sweat all the time. Like even your ball sweat's red. You know?
Yeah.
Doesn't that look
especially
weird?
Especially the ball sweat.
No,
that would just look normal for me.
Yeah.
Just
like...
How is this TV like this is no interesting TV.
Sure ain't.
Do you worry your food is safe enough to eat? Well, worry no more. Introducing the Thermo Sensor Thingy, using advanced infrared specialized scientific technology to measure the temperature of your food. Just listen to these ecstatic customers who've tried it out for themselves.
It's a great idea, yeah, because I wasn't expecting anything like this.
Amazing.
But that's not all. Not only does the Thermo Sensor Thingy measure the temperature of food, it measures the temperature of absolutely everything. Just look at this.
Oh, here we go. You hit it.
Can you see how hot my junk is?
It's your body temperature.
38.
Oh, it's a bit warm.
Get the doctor out.
What's cold, sweetheart?
Oh, really?
It's fucking 28.
Oh, put it down my pants. We thought we could do it for you.
Big brother's waiting.
Oh, okay. 5, 6, 7. Me 40 socks, me stubbies, me wife beater, me Phoebe, me Tim Tam. Because I'm Australian.
Big Brother is sure that Australia will be proud.
Yeah!
To save Sharnay, call 1902-559504, SMS Sharnay to 199-5599, or vote on Facebook.
I hate these mirrors.
Yeah, they're not good.
They're not even mirrors. They're like, I can't even see myself. It's like being in the dark and trying to look into a mirror.
Is there a river in Adelaide?
Yeah, the River Torrens.
Is it yuck?
Yeah, it's rank.
Would you rather drink a bucket of that water?
Oh, hypotheticals. Good. Oh,
or a pint.
Love this.
A pint of piss.
A bucket. Who's from
piss?
The, a bucket.
Is it like your own piss?
Let me extrapolate some more about this because it grows. So yeah, a pint of stranger's piss, lukewarm.
Ooh.
Actually no, chilled. It's been chilled overnight. Or a bucket of Adelaide River water.
Yeah, I'll take the piss.
All right.
I'd take the river water.
Dude. Piss.
You don't know like what he like what the stranger has. He's gonna have like an STI or something.
I'll cop an STI. 600 strangers piss in the river.
Would you rather sleep with a real life Marge Simpson? As in she's yellow. Bitch is yellow. She's also two dimensional. Or Roseanne.
Oh, Marge Simpson. Marge. Oh, that's disgusting. Marge. That is, that's deplorable.
Hands down, Marge Simpson, bro. Sure.
Would you rather sweat paprika?
Paprika? Isn't that like a herb?
It's like a red spice.
Red spice.
It's red, bright red. Or once a year, no, make that once a month, you shit involuntary at any time.
So you sweat.
So you can either live like a sweat-free life where you don't sweat, you know, you try to keep everything cool, or if you do get sweaty, you know, you'll just get this red glaze all over you. It's not dangerous, it just looks odd. Or once every month, the situation totally unknowns to you, you shit yourself. I mean, you could be on the toilet and it happens, and that would be truly a blessing.
No, I reckon I'll take the involuntary shitting.
Would you wear a nappy?
Yeah, there's ways around it.
I'd take the sweating paprika.
You covered him red non-stop. You sweat all the time. Like even your ball sweat's red. You know?
Yeah.
Doesn't that look weird?
Especially the ball sweat. No. That...
Oh, God. Oh, sorry about
Big
that.
Big brother, can I ask you a question?
You may.
Do you actually look like an older version of Justin Bieber?
That's a really random question.
Because it's Big Bieber.
Big Brother looks like Big Brother.
Yeah.
Is there anything else?
We're going to do a little something for you.
If you wish.
Layla obviously was quite un-Australian before she hopped into this little house. And I thought, you know what? I see a little diamond in the rough here and I'm going to take her and I'm gonna just sharpen her up a little bit and I'm gonna teach her about how to be Australian. So we did a little dance and I thought I'd just like, just we thought we could do it for you.
Big Brother's waiting.
Oh,
okay. 5, 6, 7. Me footy socks, me stubbies, me wife beater, me Phoebe, me Tim Tam, cause I'm Australian.
Big Brother is sure that Australia will be proud.
Yeah!
To save Sharnay, call 1902-559504, SMS Sharnay to 1995599 or vote on Facebook.
Hate these mirrors.
Yeah, they're not good.
They're not even mirrors. They're like, I'm like, I can't even see myself. It's like being in the dark and trying to look into a mirror.
Is there a river in Adelaide?
Yeah, the River Torrens.
Is it yuck?
Yeah, it's rank.
Would you rather drink a bucket of that water?
Oh, hypotheticals. Good.
Oh,
or a pint.
Love this.
A pint of piss.
But a bucket
Who's
from
piss?
The a bucket
Is it
from
like your own piss?
Let me extrapolate some more about this, because it grows. So yeah. A pint of stranger's piss, lukewarm.
Ooh.
Actually no, chilled. It's been chilled overnight. Or a bucket of Adelaide River water.
Yeah, I'll take the piss.
Alright.
I'd take the river water.
Dude. Piss.
You don't know, like, what he like what the stranger has. He's going to have, like, an STI or something.
I'll cop an STI. 600 strangers piss in the river.
Would you rather sleep with a real-life Marge Simpson? As in, she's yellow. Bitch is yellow. She's also two-dimensional. Or Roseanne.
Marge Simpson. Marge. Oh, that's disgusting.
Marge.
That is, that's deplorable.
Hands down, Marge Simpson, bro. Sure.
Would you rather sweat paprika?